Hey, I'm Jonathan, and this is rad-head. In this video, I'll try to give a deeper understanding of shapes of constant width. All these shapes here have a constant width, which means you can smoothly roll on top of them. There's quite a lot of information about these shapes online, but I couldn't find a single source with everything that interested me about these shapes, so here I am making this video. Let's start with the basics. When we think about a rolling object, the first thing that comes to mind is something round, like a sphere or a cylinder. Here, it's easy to imagine how the board rolls against the cylinder. The basic demand for smooth rolling in this case is that the distance between the board and the table remains the same. As it turns out, there are other shapes that satisfy this basic demand. This roller has a special shape, called the Reuleaux Triangle, which is the simplest shape of constant width. If we want to understand why this shape behaves this way, we should first see how it's constructed. We'll start with an equilateral triangle. Now, using a compass, we can replace every side with an arc centered at the opposite vertex. Now we can start exploring what happens when rolling it between two planes. At any given moment, one plane is touching a vertex and the other plane is touching an arc. Remember that the arc is centered around this specific vertex, so no matter where we are on the arc, the distance to the vertex is constant and equal to the radius of the arc. Another way of thinking about the Reuleaux triangle is as the shape enclosed by three circles with the same radius, positioned at a constant distance from each other. If you're planning on placing a heavy load on this roller, let's say a grown man, then from an engineering standpoint, it would make sense to avoid these pointy edges of the classical Reuleaux triangle, which will probably deform. Fortunately, we can easily solve this by constructing a rounded version of the Reuleaux triangle. We'll again start with an equilateral triangle, only this time we'll extend the sides just a little bit. Now, if we draw an arc between two adjacent lines, so that the center of the arc coincides with the crossing point of the two lines we're connecting, we still get a shape of constant width, this time with no sharp edges. The construction of the Reuleaux triangle could be easily generalized into any regular polygon with an odd number of sides, like this pentagon for example. And even non-regular polygons can be constructed to form a shape of constant width, like this right triangle here. A nice way to smooth the edges of a sharp-edged shape of constant width is to take a washer and slide a marker around the shape. This result is identical to the shape obtained by extending the lines of the triangle. This method will work for any shape of constant width. It turns out you can create shapes of constant width by sliding one shape around the other. The sliding rules are strict and pretty hard to demonstrate with physical shapes. They are as follows. Leave one shape stationary. Choose a point on the second shape and slide it over the perimeter of the first. Now comes the tricky part. Do not change the orientation of the second shape while sliding it. The shape traced here is our new shape of constant width, and is not dependent on the point chosen to slide over. This is exactly what we did when we slid the washer around our pointy shapes. In that case, it was equivalent of sliding a circle, which is of course a shape of constant width. These sliding rules are a simple geometric representation of a usually more complex to grasp mathematical operation, called the Minkowski sum. An interesting point worth mentioning is that using this sliding technique to slide a flipped version of the same shape will always result in a circle with diameter twice the width of the original shapes. This interesting property is used to prove that all shapes with the same width also have the same circumference, and is of course equal to pi times the width. Until now, all our constructions relied on stitching together different radii circle arcs. You might ask yourself if this is the only way of constructing shapes of constant width. As it turns out, you can also construct shapes like this one, which has no circular arcs at all. You can find more information about this shape and all others on my website. The link is in the description. Despite the fact that these shapes roll freely between two planes, do not be tempted to connect an axle in the middle and hook it to your bike. The center doesn't hold its distance from the table, as we can clearly see here. You might assume that the simple construction of the Reuleaux triangle can be easily extended to three dimensions. Simply take the intersection of four equally spaced spheres. This results in a pretty cool looking Reuleaux tetrahedron. However, this is not a solid of constant width. The reason this doesn't work is that in 2D, if one side touches a vertex, the other side always touches an arc. In 3D, this could work, as long as one surface is touching a vertex and the other is resting on the opposite spherical dome. However, we have the case in which the two surfaces are resting on the sides of the tetrahedron, which are a little farther apart, and our simple construction did not take care of this case. By rounding three of the edges, so that only one of every two opposing edges is rounded, we can turn this into a solid of constant width, known as a Meissner tetrahedron. Another simpler way of constructing solids of constant width is by simply rotating a two-dimensional shape of constant width about one of its symmetry axes. From this angle, it's clear that the cross-section of these two shapes is identical, and they roll together smoothly. All these 3D printed shapes are designed to have the exact same width as all of the other shapes, so they could all roll happily together. If you want to see how I built this set of shapes, together with a giant version that I can actually stand on, then check out the build video I made. You can also find additional information, including templates and 3D models, on my website. If you enjoyed this video and want to help me produce more like it, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Until next time, bye!